Hi listeners, welcome to the ARM Controller Lab. I am Naveen Kumar, a lecturer in ENC Department, Government Polytechnic, Ulbogal. In this session, we are going to write a program that is capable of searching and storing all the negative numbers in an array of 32-bit numbers. This is the table of content through which I am going through. Prerequisites required for understanding the program, specific objectives, course outcome, methodology, and we identify some positive and negative numbers, the flow chart, working of some instructions that are useful for writing the program, and the particular assembly language program, and the contents of register and memory locations after each iteration, then assessment, then finally with the activity. What are the prerequisites required for understanding the program? We have to have knowledge on ARM core architecture, including the register set, ARM instruction set, number system, and signed and unsigned numbers. What is the specific objective? We must be able to write an assembly language program to search and store negative numbers from array of numbers, and to run this program on the IDE, Integrated Development Environment, and to check whether it works properly or not. What is the course outcome that we are going to achieve? After having run the programs of similar manner, we are going to analyze the assembly language programs, and we are going to understand what is the procedure to execute assembly language programs with a simulator by using the IDE. Now, there must be a logic behind to write the program. What is the methodology we follow? We are aware that in signed number representation, the negative numbers are represented in their 2's complement form, and then they are stored in the memory. And the most significant bit of these negative numbers is always 1. That is, if MSB bit is 0, it indicates that the number is positive. Thus, just by determining the MSB of a given number, we can say that whether the number is positive or negative. This is the logic. Now let us consider one negative number, that is -2. 2 is represented in binary notation as 10. You can notice that here. This is how we are going to store here. First, we convert it into equivalent 2's complement form. That is, first taking 1's complement form, then adding 1 to it. Then we get some number. That number is going to be stored in the memory, right? Which is equivalent to 2. That is, note that the MSB of these negative numbers are stored, the MSB for negative numbers in their 2's complement form, right? Now let us identify the positive and negative numbers just by observation. You just notice the number. You just consider the most significant digit, that is 5. That is 0101 when it is converted into equivalent binary. That is, you consider most significant bit now, which is 0. So it indicates that this particular number is positive number. Now consider the second number. Here also, you just see or notice the most significant digit, which is D. You replace that with a binary equivalent, then the MSB will be becoming 1, then this particular number is negative. In the similar manner, when 8 is converted into binary, its equivalent is 1000, and MSB is 1, the number is negative. This is how we are capable of identifying the negative number just by observing the most significant digit and most significant bit. Now let us go through the flow chart. Flow chart is nothing but a graphical representation of a solution to the problem, right? And we are dealing with the array of numbers. Usually these array of numbers are stored in the lookup table. Lookup table stores the array of numbers in consecutive memory location so that we can access easily. First, we'll go with the start and initialize a counter or a loop counter which is equal to number of elements in the array, and take another variable that is I is equal to 0. Read array of I in the first iteration, I will be 0. Array of 0 will be indicating the first number in the array. Then that will be that we will be reading and we will copy it to the num. And we will check the MSB of this particular number. We are aware that just the MSB indicates whether the number is negative or positive. Then if the MSB is 1, what does it mean? If the MSB is 1, the number is negative, so store the number. If the MSB is 0, the number is positive, don't do anything, just go for checking another number. So that is why increase the index by 1 and decrease the loop counter by 1. So we are done with the one number. And now you check the loop counter for 0. Loop counter 0 indicates that we have done with all the numbers and stop the program. If the loop counter is not 0, still there are the number to check. So go back to the reading the array element. Now the index is increased by 1. Now the array of 1 will be indicating the second number in the array. Likewise, we are going to read the numbers one by one until all the numbers are checked. Whenever all the numbers are checked, this loop counter will be 0. Then we are going to stop the program at that particular point. Now let us understand some useful instructions which are necessary for writing the program. First, we will consider BPL instruction, right? BPL instruction actually checks the negative flag or N flag of CPSR conditional flags. If N flag is equal to 0, it transfers the control to the label associated with it, or else the execution continues with the next instruction following it, right? Now I have given a piece of code. See, BPL positive, and then add instruction, then subtract instruction. There are two cases before executing the BPL positive. Assume that if n is equal to 1, BPL will not transfer the control to the positive, then the add instruction is executed followed by subtract instruction, right? Whenever if n is equal to 0 before executing the BPL instruction, then the branching to the label positive takes place, then only subtract instruction will be executed. Now consider the BNE instruction, branch not equal to 0. As the name itself indicates, it takes the control to the label associated with whenever 0 flag is equal to non-zero. That is, if 0 flag is equal to 0, indicates that the result of previous operation is non-zero, then take the control to the label. So here I have given a piece of code, that is subtract instruction, subtract R3 by 1 and then store the result in R3, then branch not equal to repeat. Here, until unless the R3 becomes 0, 0 flag will not be equal to 1. Until the zero flag is zero, the control go back to the repeat. Thus, the subtraction instruction is executed until the R3 becomes 0. After all the iterations, that is when R3 becomes 0, Z flag will become 1, then BNE will not take the control to the repeat. Thus, move R5,1 instruction will be executed. That is, usually this BNE instruction is used for checking the loop counter, whether we have done with all the iterations or not. This is the purpose of BNE instruction. Now, working of comparison instruction. Comparison instruction compares two numbers and updates the result in CPSR register. Actually, it performs subtraction operation. Consider an example that is given here. Compare R0, R9. it subtracts R9 from R0, and the result will not be updated into the register, but it reflects in the CPSR register. In the given example, you can see the CPSR contents. The lower case indicates that the particular bit is 0, and the upper case indicates that particular bit is 1. Here, F I have given capital letter indicating that first interrupt request is 1. So here, both R0 and R9 contents are 0. Whenever subtraction operation is performed, the result will be 0 and the 0 flag will become 1. This is indicated by uppercase letter after the execution. That you can notice. And the result of subtraction operation is not updated. That is, the result is discarded. Now, let us see the working of LDR instruction. We are aware that LDR and STR instructions are used for moving the contents between the registers and memory. But apart from that, LDR is also used as a pseudo instruction for loading the 32-bit constant into a register. We are aware that the ARM controller is a 32-bit microcontroller, and there cannot be any 32-bit integer in the instruction or 32-bit value in the instruction. Thus, there is no instruction that can move a 32-bit value directly into a register. That's why we use the LDR instruction. Here, LDR R1 will be loaded with a constant. Actually, it will be converted into a memory read operation. Initially, this content or immediate 32-bit value will be stored into the memory, and then that value will be read from the memory and stored in the R1. That is why it is called pseudo instruction. Let us go through the program. Here, the area directive along with the data initializes a section of memory or a block of memory that is capable of storing the data with the name store. And we are able to perform both read and write operation with that particular data. And here the variable result will be pointing to the first memory location in that memory block. And one more area directive we are using, that is going to define a piece of memory location or reserve a piece of memory location for storing the instruction. That is, we are indicating using the code directive. And we are able to perform only read-only operation, right? In this program, first we need to perform initialization operation. We assume that the array of elements are stored at the memory location 400001000, and the count of these numbers, that is number of elements, will be stored at this particular memory location, that is 400000200, right? This particular count will be loaded to the R2. That is, R2 is being used as a loop counter. And the result where it has to be stored, that particular memory location, that is starting memory location, will be loaded to the R7. These set of memory locations will be performing iterative operations. That is, they will be reading a number from the memory and checks whether it is a positive number or negative number. If it is a negative number, it will be stored in the result memory. If it is a positive number, then no operation will be performed and the next number will be checked. This particular iterations are repeated until all the numbers are checked, right? See here, in the LDR R6, R0, here we are loading the elements one by one from the memory into the R6. Whenever the element is positive, then the negative flag will be 0. When the negative flag will be 0, BPL next will take place, then the control comes here. Then the R0 will be incremented by 4 so that we are able to point to the next element in the array. And subtraction instruction will decrease the loop counter by 1, indicating that we are done with the number. And BN instruction checks the 0 flag. Since the R2 is not 0, the 0 flag will be 0 itself. So it takes the control back to the repeat. Then again, another element will be read from the memory location, which will be moved to the R6. then again the R6 will be compared with the zero. If R6 is negative value, then negative N flag will be one. This it will not take the control to the next. Then STR R6 comma 7 will be executed. This particular one will indicate that the number is negative. Store that particular number into a memory location. So once we store a number in a memory location, the address has to be increased by the 4 so that the next number, negative number, will be stored in that particular memory location. That is why increase the result memory by 4. Again, we have to access the next element so that you add R0. So you add 4 to the R0 register and the result is stored in the R0. Again, you check the R2 loop counter, whether it is zero. If it is zero, all the numbers are checked. So go to stop, right? This B stop is unconditional instruction. It will just simply takes the control back to the stop. Now let us execute the program in IDE. So there can be a number of IDE tools available for usage. So we are using Keel here. There can be a number of IDEs like CoIDE, RIDE, Eclipse. Likewise, we are using Keel IDE. So first we need to create a project. You give any name, say Project 7, save it. In this, I'm using Keel version 5.22. In this particular version, I need to select legacy device database and type LPC 2148, for which we have written the assembly language program. It details the features of that particular IC. So it asks for whether to copy startup file to the project and add file to the project. You have to say no. Now we have to create our ASM file in the editor window. So I have already have a typed program. Just I'll copy from here to there. Right. And now save it. So I'll save the project and it's a PGM7, and we should not forget that we should give the extension as .s to indicate the assembler that it is an assembly language program. Now save it. So now you link your assembly language program to the project. You select add existing file. Here you select ASM file because we are writing a assembly language program. Then here we have given a name as project program 7. Then you click on add. So here the number will be added. So you click on close. Now you can notice that the file has appeared here. Now once the file is added, you have to build it. So you right click on source group, select build. So you notice that there are zero errors. If there are any errors, it denotes the line number where the error has occurred. You need to check in that particular line. Right. Now let us give the input so that you need to start or stop debug session. You say okay. So here I said that the input numbers are stored from the memory location with the starting address 400001000. So you give that particular address. That is, the input numbers are stored as 400010. Here you can notice that. You give any number, it follows little endian format. So the MS digit has to occur here. First, I'll give the negative number. Right, this MS digit F indicates that it is a negative number. Then I'll give a positive number. Then again, I'll give the negative number, say 80, 11, 25. Then I'll give one more negative number, that is D1, 65, 85. Right. Then I'll give one positive number. Right? We have given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let us give one more number. So I'll give one more negative number, say E0, 25, 58, say some random number. So I have given total 6 numbers. So this count has to be given at 200. So here you give 06. Having given this input, now we can go for checking the output. If you run this once for all, the output comes. So we can also check it stepwise. So here also we can click. Now you see that the memory location where the array elements are stored appears here. Now again stepwise, so see the count where the count of elements as stored, they appear here. Then the count will be loaded to the R2 by using the LDR instruction. Right? Then the result memory location has to be loaded into the R7 by using this particular instruction. Now the first number that comes to R7, since it is negative number, when we use compare instruction, the N flag will be 1. Now you can notice that in CPSR register, that is N flag is equal to 1. Since N flag is equal to 1, we need to save that in the memory. Right? So now this STR instruction will save that in the memory. Now we can see that. See, the first number has appeared here. Now, keep on checking. Now, the address of the memory location of next element is increased by 4, so that we can access it. Now, we decrease the loop counter by 1, saying that we have done with one number. Since the loop counter is not 0, the BNE instruction will take the control back to the repeat. Now, the LDR instruction will be executed, where the next element will be read from the memory. See, now the next element has come to the R2 register, R6 register. Since the number is positive, we are not going to store it, and this negative flag will become 0. See, it has already become 0. Since the negative flag has become 0, it will take the control to the next. See, it has come here. That is, we have done with one more number, then go for checking the another number, right? So if we keep on doing this, see, the next number has arrived here. So this has to be done until the loop counter becomes 0. whenever loop counter becomes zero, the program automatically stops. See, it has come to end. Now you see, I have given four negative numbers, all have been stored here, right? So this is how to execute the program. This we have understood, the program part. Now let us see the contents of register and memory location after each iteration. See, I have taken different example over here. Just by seeing the most significant digit, we can observe whether the number is positive or not. See, the most significant digit is 1. The binary equivalent of this is 0001. So MS bit is 0. This is positive number. So since it is positive number, the memory location is not incremented by 1. Since second number is negative number, then MSB is 1, so it is negative number, and store in this particular memory location and increase the memory location by 1 so that we can store the next number. This continues for all the 4 numbers, right? And see, this is how the result memory looks like for the given input numbers. There are 4 negative numbers which are stored in the memory location like this. Right? And where exactly this type of programming is useful? We are very much familiar with the deep neural networks and machine learning nowadays. Deep learning, machine learning are very much popular. That is, application part of them are Google Assistant and Alexa, likewise. Right? In such neural networks, we use convolutional neural networks. In that convolution neural network, there is one particular operation called ReLU activation. In ReLU activation, we replace all the negative numbers with the 0 to retain the non-linearity property of the image. So see here, in the feature map, if the negative number is 0, it will be replaced with 0. Right? If there is a positive number, it will be retained as it is. So this is one application of this particular program. Now let us see, after having run the program on the Keel IDE and after having gone through the entire presentation, let us see what have we understood so far. MSB of negative numbers is same as positive number, 0, 1, minus 1. Of course, MSB of negative numbers is 1, so the answer is C. Now, BPL instruction tests dash flag to take decision on branching. Of course, it checks N flag, so the answer is B. Lookup table stores the array of elements in the consecutive memory location and useful for assessing the number sequentially, both A and B, none of the above. Of course, both A and B are true. The answer is C. Now the instruction BPL branches to the label if, which flag it checks actually? It checks the N flag. So of course the only option is B. Now consider a piece of code or set of instruction. Just go through the instruction and come to conclusion that how many times the subtraction instruction is executed, right? So this particular instruction is executed 4 times, because until it becomes 0, the BNE repeat will take the control back to sub instruction itself, right? That is, the answer is D. Now consider a move instruction where we are moving a 32-bit value to a register. What is the answer? A, loads R3 with immediate value, add R3 with that particular value, move R3 contents to the memory location, or invalid instruction. Answer is D. Why? Because I said that there is no instruction that can move the 32-bit contents into a register, because ARM is a 32 bit microcontroller where the width of the instruction is 32 bit in size. Now in signed numbers, dash bit indicates the sign of the number, right? Whether the number is positive or not, which bit indicates it? That is MSB, most significant digit bit. Answer is B. Now identify the negative numbers from the following 32 bit signed numbers. To identify, we need to consider only most significant digit, that is 7 and 8. Just convert these particular numbers into binary and then decide. Here, when 7 is converted, it will be 0111. So 0 indicates that it is a positive number. And consider A. So when it is converted into binary, the equivalent number is 1010, and the MSB of 1 indicates that it is a negative number. So which number is negative? Second number. So the answer is B. In memory, the negative numbers are stored in, right? Which is the answer? Straight away answer, it is stored in 2's complement form. That is answer is A. Now consider a piece of code over here. We are familiar with the BNE instruction. Now BNE instruction will branch to the next if zero flag is zero, right? See, we are loading 1 to the R3 register, then R3 will be shifted, right? So that R3 becomes 0. When R3 becomes 0, 0 flag will be equal to 1. Since 0 flag will be equal to 1, BNE will not take the control to the next. That is, move R1 comma 01 will be executed, then it will go to down here unconditionally. So after executing the sequence of instructions, on the contents of R1 are this one, that is 1, right? The answer is B. Now let us do some activity after having learned this particular program. You write an assembly language program to count and store the negative numbers in NRF 16 bit numbers. So we dealt with the 32 bit numbers. Now you deal with 16 bit integers, and also you need to count the number of negative numbers, right? And you write an assembly language program to count and separate positive and negative numbers in NRF 8 bit numbers. You need to deal with 8 bit numbers, and also you need to separate positive numbers and negative numbers over here. Now you write an assembly language program to replace negative numbers with 0 and retain positive numbers in NRF 32 bit integers. Here, as we explained in the application part of the program, like ReLU activation, you replace the negative numbers with 0 and retain all the positive numbers. And you run all these programs on IDE like Keil and test their working. Right? So thank you. Thank you one and all. I'm ending the session.